Hello everyone, my name is Michelle and this is my channel LenisseCrochet. If you are new to my channel, welcome, and if you are already subscribed, welcome back. Today is Sunday and I decided to just go ahead and work on the projects that I just have halfway done, just piling up. So yesterday I did all the errands that I needed to do. I went to the store, laundry, etc. And today, even though I felt like doing something else, because you always want to procrastinate, I said, no, let me just set aside some time. The house is quiet, I have my projects, and so I will dedicate today, Sunday, to just completing my unfinished crochet projects. All right, so I'm gonna show you the first one that I'll be working on, and I know it's just gonna be halfway until the yarn lasts, because one of my main goals today is just not to go out and stay in and crochet. And I haven't done this in a while, so it doesn't happen often. I don't know why, it just feels like a crime if I just set time aside and start crocheting. I feel like I'm just, I don't know, committing a crime because there's so much other stuff that I should be doing. But this is also my passion. I do want to make a business out of it. And if I don't dedicate time towards it, it's just never gonna happen. So here we go. This is, let me see if I can even get it together. It's supposed to be a top. I'm going to link the tutorial that I'm using for this. Passion knits something. I know a lot of you are going to recognize that name, but I will tag it. So she posted that she was making this one, and she tagged the person that had this pattern, so I'm gonna tag her as well. All right, so this is so far what I have, and this is the only part that I have left for the yarn. So I'm gonna do today as much as it lets me with this yarn without having to go out. Okay, my next project, because I know that the yarn is gonna run out eventually, I have all these sunflowers. Let me see. So I have to get rid of the ends and all that good stuff, which is not my favorite thing to do. And then I have all the leaves ready. Well, they're not ready. I have to just weave in the ends and then wrap the yarn around the wire, just get them ready. I think there's 20. And then I will just start doing the sunflowers. So this is, we can call it our second project, potentially. And then another thing that I'm doing, it's funny that I'm just, I have, how do you say it? I guess I believe in myself a lot. I'm truly believing that I'm going to finish all these projects today. This is going to be a bear because I am also making patterns, and I have a separate website. It is Pinkdinocrochet, and I will link it as well if it lets me. And I, this side note, I have LenisseCrochet and I've had it for over 10 years, and I don't want to just pick one niche. I don't want to just either choose plushies or flowers or baby stuff. I just want it to be like very general. I want to be able to crochet whatever I feel like. So that'll be LenisseCrochet. But I also like plushies and I like all this kawaii stuff. And so I just open up a shop and an Instagram and a TikTok as well. Just dedicated to plushies, and so I can just let my imagination run and do patterns however I just want them to be. So anyways, this is going to be a teddy bear. So I am crocheting, taking pictures, writing down the patterns, undoing it, trying it again. So this is a little bit more complicated. This might be towards the end of the day type of project. And then lastly, if I end up having a lot of time in my hands, I just have these. Oh, I hope I don't get banned for showing the bag. Lavender. So it would be also just getting rid of the ends, which I don't ever like to cut them because I'm always afraid after so much work, if I cut them, I don't want it to be like unraveled. So I sew all my ends. I know, I just feel like I'm cheating if I glue it, or I don't know, if I just cut it too short and call it a day. So far we have, well, I have 4 projects. I think I'm gonna start with this one, which I already memorized the stitches. I can do this while watching TV, relaxing, and then I will jump to the next one. All right, let's see how far I go today with my projects. When you got what you want, baby, I should start over. Okay, so then this is as far as I got with the yarn. Right before the part that you are supposed to join in the sleeves. So I am thinking I'm gonna need about 2 more of these yarn skeins. So hopefully that'll be it. So this is it for the first project for now. Now we're going to start doing the flowers. It is thundering right now, so I don't know if you guys hear it. I know that my dog is here with me because she is super scared. She's shaking, so I have to give her medicine. She's not a fan of the rainstorm, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that as well. And I wanted to mention what type of yarn I'm using. I'm gonna post it. It is at Joann's. It is 100% cotton. I think it's going to be a little bit too loose, but since it's cotton, I'm hoping if I wash it, it'll shrink a little bit. So let's see. But for now, let's jump to project number 2. All right, now let's jump to our second project. I do want to mention that April is fine. She is doing a lot better after her medicine. It just happened everything at once. It started raining. When I saw her, she was already shaking. No one went out. They all stayed at home, so they were watching TV. I ended up doing something off camera, which is weaving the ends of all the flowers, because I just wanted to use my time as much as possible because it was raining and I couldn't record because it was gonna be too noisy. So this part is done. And now we are going to do the, I don't know why I keep saying we, it's just me. I am going to do the leaves for the flowers, with the exception of this one. And I do want to ask you guys, which one do you like better? I like this one because it gives it kind of like a rustic look, but I also like this light green, which it's like more like spring. So which one do you guys like? All right, so now we're going to do this part, and I do want to show you kind of a tutorial up close of how I do this. So this is not like an actual tutorial, it's just to show you what I do with the leaves. So if it ends up working for you, then good. All right, so the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to just weave in this end. And at the same time, it's just kind of just secure the leaf. You have to be careful that you're going in the same direction that you crochet. Don't go this way because you're just gonna unravel the circle. So just make it tight. I'm left-handed, so I go the opposite way if you're not a lefty. You just kind of keep doing this so it feels tight. All right, and there you go. So now we're gonna cut this part. All right, so we are done with that. Now, this is just wrapping the wire. It's not focused, there. We're just gonna wrap the wire with the yarn, but at the same time, I'm not gonna be working with these leaves yet, so we need to secure it because they're just gonna be all done and they're gonna go back in a bag until I have the time to do the flowers. So I'm gonna show you how to secure it at the end. So we're going to twist the wire about 3 times. And now we're going to tightly wrap the wire. All right, so now that we are almost at the end, you're going to go in between the wire and you're going to twist it a few times. And there you go. That is how I do my leaves. So I'm gonna do this same process with about 20 of them. And then I will just do the leaves whenever I get a chance. But today on my to-do list, it was just getting the leaves ready, you know, baby steps. So now I'm gonna sit down and just complete these. I've been saying for the longest, these are 20, there's only 12. So I should be able to do this fairly fast. Then after that, I am dreading the pattern part. Because it's not actually crocheting, it's a lot of Word document, computer, just proofreading, and it's not as fun, but we'll see if I get to do it. I wish I could switch it for something else now that I'm halfway through the video. All right, but let's start. I also fixed my hair because I was trying to have like baby hairs, but now that I was looking back at the recent videos, it just looked like I just had gotten out of bed. So hopefully it looks a little bit better. All right, let's start. All right, so here are all the leaves. They are done, everything is wrapped, the wire is ready. So this just makes it easier when you just get them all ready and then you start assembling. When I start wrapping the stem with the yarn, I just attach it, and then whatever is left, I just cut it when it gets closer. So this is ready for the flowers, and I'll show you a picture of what the sunflowers would look like at the end because I already have some that are finished. Okay, so it's going to be about 5 o'clock right now. I had to start dinner, but it's a meat that I'm gonna just leave in the oven for about 2 hours on low. So that's going to give me enough time to just keep working on another project. So I will get back to you as soon as I'm done with that, and then we will start hopefully working on the pattern. Okay, so now dinner is in the oven. I have about half an hour to start working on the crochet pattern. I already have half of it, the written part, in my Canva document. I just have to actually put it all together, crochet the parts, assemble, and then just, I guess, make sure that everything turns out okay as far as the measurements. So that is the part that we're going to be working now. I want to show you, this is the yarn that I'm going to be using. I got this from the dollar store. So if you guys are writing any patterns and you're just doing your first try to practice, this is great to use. Just $1 at the dollar store, or $1.25 now that they raise their prices. So this is the one that I'm going to be using, and I already have parts of it done, so let me show you. Okay, so I want to show you the parts that I have so far. This, believe it or not, is going to be the head, because I want it to be bigger than the body. So let's see if it turns out like I see it in my head. So this would be the head and the body. And now I have, let me see, I think these are the little arms. And then these would be the tiny legs. So as far as the brown parts, I think I'm done with making the parts, except I'm missing the ears. But this pattern, how I see it in my head, it's supposed to have a hat, like a hoodie. So this would be the part that I'm gonna be working on now. My goal here is to keep making the hat as big as the head. And then once it reaches the same measurements, I'm gonna keep adding rows so it actually covers the head. But I can't do this part without stuffing the bear, so I guess I can do that first. So let me start working on this and then I'll show you the progress. Okay, I'm already realizing that even though I have the same amount of rows as far as the part that we do the increase, this is a thinner yarn, so I can either start all over with a different yarn so it matches the brown that I'm using for the bear, or I can add another row. But when someone is using the pattern, they're supposed to have the same yarn, so I should start with the same yarn as well. So I don't know, this is what I was talking about. Doing a pattern, it's sometimes it's complicated. So I'm gonna then go ahead and find a different type of yarn so it matches this one. Otherwise my rows are just not gonna be even. So I would love to say that I'm gonna keep working on this, but I'm probably going to just jump to the next project, which is just assembling a few of my my lavenders. But yeah, as far as this, it's gonna be on standby. Yeah, that's my son trying to be part of the video, and I know that you guys can see the tripod. I guess I have to purchase the one that I've seen on TikTok. Okay, sorry about that. I guess I knew from the beginning that I really didn't want to work on the pattern, and I just saw that as an opportunity to put it aside. I have to get a different yarn and just start from scratch, and I'm not gonna have the time to do that tonight if I want to finish this video. You guys maybe can hear why. So let me just jump. Okay, let's just start with the lavender.
Mommy.
2, 3. Okay guys, so the next project is going to be making just a few lavender flowers. however many I get to do tonight. But I do want to show you what they would look like at the end. These, I've been working on them forever, and I think I'm just making flowers, getting ready for February or Mother's Day next year, even though it's June now. I don't know, I just like making flowers. I do have them on my Etsy shop and the sunflowers as well. So I don't have any orders or anything. I just feel the need to just stock up on flowers. So when the time comes, I just have a lot of merchandise. But I use a different type of yarn. Some end up being completely purple and some end up being completely pink. And then here is the mixed one. So what I use is just one yarn. I can't remember the name of it. I'm sure I can post it as well. But it ends up being very convenient because you're using just the same yarn. You don't have to switch colors, and it ends up being a little bit realistic, I want to say. So let's see if I have time to just at least assemble a few so I can show you guys the process. All right, so now I'm going to show you a little bit of the process on how I make the lavender flowers. I'm going to use this thin stem. It's already green, but I'm also going to wrap it around with yarn, and it's more so the same color. So the very first step that we're going to do, I'm going to just find a thicker part of the lavender flower. I'm gonna put glue. There we go. And then you're going to secure it. Wait a little bit. I think I put too much glue. And we're going to use just a tiny bit of glue. And then you start twisting. Well, if I have it in the camera, it will be better. A little bit of glue. So we're actually just gluing the part that has the chain. A little bit more now that we are getting towards the end. And now we secure that part. So we start with glue, just a little bit there. I haven't assembled one of these in a while, so I am lacking practice and I forget the measurements for the yarn. Okay. There we go. Okay, so we have that part, and we're going to put just a tiny bit of glue. And we're going to do the same with the leaves. I know it looks a bit complicated. It's just because I'm trying to do everything in front of the camera. If I had, I guess, free space, I would just be moving the stem a bunch of different directions to try to make the leaves stay in place. But try my best here. So now it's just the easy part, which is just churning around the stem. I'm just gonna put more glue. I'm going to go till the end, and then I'm going back, just doing one more round of the yarn. All right, just like that. Cut it. And we need more glue. So, I like to melt it. Later on, I guess I can use the lighter to seal it, but since this stem is so thin, I'm afraid that the yarn is going to unravel if I don't just melt it all together. So okay, so here we go. This is our first lavender. So now I'll just make as many as I can and I will call it a night. How do you guys like it? All right, guys, so that is it for this video. If you made it this far, thank you for watching the video. Don't forget to subscribe. I know it ended up being a little bit hectic towards the end with dinner. It's the end of the day, it's Sunday, kids, etc. I have to get ready for work tomorrow. And I didn't necessarily get to finish that many projects, but as it is, I was just doing a little bit of each. So if you consider yourself a procrastinator, even though sometimes it's just not that, it's just lack of time, or just find that you have a lot of unfinished crochet projects, maybe this would be a good idea just to give yourself a little bit of a challenge. Just don't try to do a major project. Just like I did today, I just had four different projects and I think I advanced maybe 10% on each of them. If you are a mom and you're trying to maybe make it on your crochet business, or you are a content creator, just know that it can be done. I just did this last minute. It went from, the house is quiet, I think I can do a TikTok, to, it's very, very quiet, I think I can just do a whole video. And things ended up happening in between. It was a little bit crazy, but it was done. So no big deal, it's real life. If you're thinking of starting a crochet business, just give it a go. The first thing you have to do is start. Thank you for watching my video. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye.